Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and today is April 19th, 2021, which means we have a new hour of work to do. I'm so glad you're here. It's a Monday. I've got that start of the week energy. I'm feeling good. It's the first day of the second to last week of April. Look how far we've come. I love to see it. It feels incredible. If you've never been here before, welcome. You should know that this is a video I made for you to work along with. You have found yourself in a co-working space. We will do 1 hour at the desk. It will be divided into two 25-minute parts. That's right, we're gonna work in real time using the Pomodoro technique. During those 25 minutes, we're gonna listen to white noise and we're gonna focus on the task at hand. What counts as a task? Oh, I don't know, anything you need to do? Right in the middle, we'll have a 5-minute break where you can get up and refill your beverages, maybe stretch, maybe research the perfect candle online. Take that time for yourself. It is a break. I will be here, of course, chatting about a certain subject, and today we will continue our conversation about rejection. I do have some juicy tidbits for you. So if you want some human interaction, you can stay with me. And then after the break, we'll do our second 25-minute work section. And then after that, we close our computers, we walk away, we go out into the world knowing we already showed up, we already took care of business. I mean, what an incredible feeling for the rest of the day, knowing you already have that hour under your belt. I love it. Today, I'm drinking an ice water and a hot coffee with chocolate almond milk. I'm going to be working on my newsletter, which I'm going to talk about during the break, because I have decided to revamp it for this month to focus on rejection. I'd love to know what your beverages are and what you plan on working on. Great. Well, without further delay, let's jump into this first 25 minutes. It will fly by. You will be shocked. I promise you that. I mean, 25 minutes really goes by like that. I will count us in. Are you ready? Are you comfortable? You got everything in front of you? You ready? Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Thank you. Ding, 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 friends. Ding, ding, ding. I'm putting 5 minutes on the old stopwatch. How we doing? We feeling good? I don't know what it is about a Monday. I know I'm supposed to hate them. That is what pop culture tells me. Can't do Mondays. I love a freaking Monday. I love feeling like I got a fresh start. Anything can happen this week. I think the only day of the week I don't like, no, I like them all. I take it back. They all serve a purpose. Listen, I want to give a shout out to the viewer who noticed that my audio was a little off last week. Thank you. You were right. That's the kind of feedback I'm looking for here, folks. We're in this together, okay? Old Ashley doesn't always know how to use her computers and her settings. So sometimes I screw up my audio. Thank you. You're looking out. I appreciate it. Okay, so let's talk about rejection, what I was going to talk about, what I've been thinking about. I love that we're going down this rabbit hole of rejection. So fun. I started doing my newsletter last week. I was struggling. I was just trying to be witty and fun, but everything that I wrote came out forced and I wasn't excited about it at all. And then I was thinking about rejection and things that I have been excited about in the past that have been rejected. I got a long line. I either go two ways with my writing. I'm either like, this is great and I'll read it over and over again forever. I love it so much. Or I'm like, this is absolute dog shit. Nothing can save it. I shouldn't even try and write. What am I doing? Who do I think I am? That's pretty much it. I guess every now and then I go, oh, I could improve this, but that is rare. So it's very painful for me when something I think is great is rejected. It has happened a few times, more than I'd like to admit, but that's the biz, babe. You know, you miss 100% of the humor essays you don't submit to McSweeney's. Is that the Michael Jordan quote? So anyway, I wrote something last year, year and a half ago. Who knows? I don't really understand time anymore since 2020 was a vacuum. But I think it was like a year and a half ago, maybe this time in 2019. I wrote something that I just thought was really funny. I really liked it. And I sent it in to McSweeney's. It got a beautiful rejection letter. I love when they're like, they say nice things in the rejection. Do you like that? I was talking to a writer before and they were like, I don't like it, because then I'm like, well, why didn't you accept it if you think it has merit or whatever? I'm like, no, give me some sugar with my medicine. Okay, let's do the Mary Poppins way of rejection. Say something sweet if you're going to tell me I didn't make the cut, forever and always. That's the secret for me. So I wrote this thing and I submitted it to McSweeney. Well, no, first I sent it to my old neighbor who I grew up next to, an English teacher. And every now and then I'll send him something I write like, this is fun. What do you think about this? Because I value his opinion. I'm nothing if not someone who desperately wants approval from English teachers forever. And he wrote back and he was like, I like it, but I don't think everyone knows that that is the case. I'll just tell you what this is. This is so self-indulgent, but here we are. So I wrote an essay. It's called Why I Don't Want to Be Famous. Why I Do Not Want to Be Famous. And it centers around this idea that I don't want to be famous because then you have to deal with Leonardo DiCaprio stealing all of your stinky cheese. That's it. Okay. So I wrote this thing and I sent it to him and he was like, I don't know if people know that about Leonardo DiCaprio. I don't know that people know that he steals stinky cheese. And I was like, well, that's something I made up for humor purposes. But I guess I failed. Nothing like when they don't get the joke. But I was like, you know what? He's out of touch. He doesn't know satire. Okay. I'm going to submit it to McSweeney's. And surely they will love it. I got a nice little rejection letter. And then you know what I did? I never touched it again. I was like, that's it. It's dead in the water. Boom. Don't. I loved it. And I'm never going to open it or read it again. But then we've been talking about rejection, and I've been thinking about rejection, and I've been reading like little rejection articles to share this week, because this week is all about rejection, by the way. So I've been reading all these things, and I was like, I'm going to make that my newsletter, and I'm going to share this essay that was rejected. So if you are interested in reading it, sign up for my newsletter. It is in the description box. And I'm going to send it out. I'm going to write like a little bit about rejection. And then I'm going to put this essay at the bottom of the email for anyone who wants to read it. And then I was like, why don't I start a freaking blog where I just post everything that's been rejected? But then I was like, do people read blogs anymore? Are blogs a thing? I remember blogger.com was a thing. Is that like a site that still exists? Anyway, these are the questions I ask myself at 3 a.m. Okay. I'm putting 25 minutes on the old stopwatch. I am going to spend this second half doing two things. I'm going to spend it returning emails and planning out this week. And then if I have time after that, I'm going to brainstorm some tweets. Tweets do not come naturally to me. I mean, they do. The ones that do well come naturally. Look, this is a whole nother conversation. But if I want to tweet every day, I got to brainstorm occasionally. Okay. It's just your basic joke writing. So why am I over explaining this? I don't know. That's what I'm going to work on. I'd love to know what you're going to work on. Great. Okay. Well, let's jump into it. I'll count us in. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go.
Thank you.
Ding, 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 ding. What a day. What a work, pal. What a week we have ahead of us. I'm putting an X on the calendar. Monday the 19th is done, babes. Guess what's next? Tuesday the 20th. Woo, look at that. Who knew that this cheap calendar from Target that I spent like $3 on at the start of the year would bring me so much pleasure? I had no idea. Thank you for working with me. I hope you feel good. Let's go out there, live our lives. Let's be, you know, let's be loose. Let's be chill, knowing we already did our work. The best feeling. I will see you here tomorrow at 10 a.m. We're going to continue to talk about rejection. Thank you so much for working with me today. Okay. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.